I think that's one really major strength about a plant-based diet is the fiber. And the other thing is that if you look at vegetarians, they tend to have, there are certain micronutrient deficiencies that are common. You mentioned vitamin B12, which is one, you know, B12 is found, it's more highly concentrated in animal meat.
Well, I mean, it used to be, I mean, really, correct me if I'm wrong, but isn't vitamin B12 a microorganism that propagates in the soil? And so it used to be that even if you were just eating plants, like they weren't washed off, they weren't as sort of sanitized as they are now, and you could get your B12 that way, but now our soils are so depleted, so now it's kind of become a thing. I mean, I sort of resist this contention or this argument that like a vegan diet is by definition sort of a deficient diet because you have to supplement with B12.
Yeah, okay. So it's not a microorganism, but it's made by microorganisms. Okay. So microorganisms,
right,
including in our
say,
gut,
yeah,
make it. And uh-huh. Guess what? Fiber.
The animals have it because yes. They're eating, they're basically, their noses are in the dirt all day.
I don't know exactly why all the animals have it, but that, yeah, there, that would make
right.
sense. Okay. So I don't think plant-based diets are like, or vegan uh-huh. diets are like inherently micronutrient deficiency. In fact, if you look at the data, many different vegetarians and vegans have more certain micronutrients, mm-hmm. folate, vitamin K, magnesium. I mean, these are all, you know, vitamin C, vitamin E. Vegans and vegetarians have a much higher concentration of these very important micronutrients. Vitamin K is extremely important. Magnesium, half the country doesn't get enough of. You know, so I don't think by definition a plant-based or vegan or vegetarian diet is a nutritionally deficient diet. I think there's certain ones they have to make sure they're getting, and there's certain ones they're getting more of than other people that, you know, aren't getting enough of these, mm-hmm. eating enough vegetables. So it really just depends. It's like, well, some, you know, vegans do have to get a little more B12. They have to get a little bit more, you know, iron, but, you know, lentils are high in iron. There's mm-hmm. a lot of, if you just know and think about what you need to eat, you can get your zinc from cashews.
Mm-hmm.
Cashews are higher in iron. Lentils are higher in iron. I mean, you can find, you know, plant-based nuts and seeds and, you know, things that are good sources of these micronutrients that you don't get if you're not getting the meat. But if you're eating a lot of meat, you're not eating a lot of, if you're eating processed foods and meat, you're not getting enough mm-hmm. vegetables, guess what? You're going to be deficient in a lot more micronutrients,
right. mm-hmm.
to be honest. So I think that it's just a matter of knowing which ones and making sure you're getting a dietary source of them, making sure if you're not getting a dietary source that you are taking a B12. And, you know, back to the B12, our gut bacteria make it. And there are certain gut bacteria that when you, like, for example, you're taking antibiotics,
mm-hmm.
Which are loaded in meat, and that we can get to that in a minute. But, you know, you kill off a lot of your own bacteria that
right.
make B12. So, you know, there's the whole, well, you want to have
right,
your gut
yeah,
healthy.
Yeah,
well, how
yeah.
do you get your gut healthy?
Mm-hmm.
You give it the right components. You give it the fiber. Your gut likes fiber. It really likes fiber and likes, you know, anything that's going to allow it to make short chain fatty acids, which are actually essentially what fuel all the gut cells inside your intestine, line your mm-hmm. intestine, fuel it. They prefer short chain fatty acids as their source of energy over anything else. So glucose, anything. They want these short chain fatty acids. And how do they get them? Fiber.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, there's that.
Right.
And that's one thing that vegetarians do get a lot of fiber. And I myself make a very, you know, I make an effort to make sure I'm getting enough fiber.
Mm-hmm.
And I eat a lot of plants, a broad spectrum of them, different colors. You know, I make right. something very similar every morning, chard, spinach.
Uh-huh.
I always have those, the green base, you know, where it's
yeah.
spinach and chard and kale and then a carrot, tomato, and some berries and, you know, different variations of it. I like the chia seeds and hemp seeds because you're also getting some of the omega-3s.
Yeah, omega-3.